Planet. This is the Spirit Man, the embracer of human good, and analyst of fiction. And now we are going to discuss The Way of the Willow, episode 15 of the Tangled series, just before the big Queen for a Day event. And boy, is that a special two-parter, to say the least. This is an Ariana episode. That's right, an episode about the Queen, about Rapunzel's mother, nonetheless. Yeah, she doesn't really do much this show thus far, has she? Much like Max and some others. But it's about time we got to her, and this is particularly about her and her sister, Willow. Willowmina, to be precise. The episode begins with Willow getting a special gift from someone who warns her to be careful with it, for if she opens it, her life will never be the same. And she says, oh yeah, got your warning. Besides, this is not for me. And we see that it's Ariana's birthday, and Rapunzel gives her a special gift. Can't remember exactly what it was. And Lance gives the Queen a tent, which is just his own tent that is very overused and such. There's one of those moments where Eugene has to take Lance aside saying, can I have a word with you about royal appropriate conversations? Soon enough, you hear out loud, where's the birthday girl? Where's the Queen? And you see Willow apparently reuniting with all the servants that she's been acquainted with in the past. Yeah, the whole thing with Ariana's backstory is kind of confusing here, so I'm assuming she was a princess. Either she and Willow were princesses, or maybe they were both ordinary women, and the king just happened to fall in love with Ariana over Willow, I guess. They don't really make that very clear. It's kind of confusing, but they have this sort of half-hearted reunion, and Willow gives Ariana this little gerbil thing. I'll just call it a gerbil thing. I forget what they said it was called. She makes it clear to Ariana that this gerbil and his little shaking toys, little bell toy, make sure he's never separated from it, so you can kind of see where this is going, especially considering that the gerbil keeps shaking the bell toy at the most inconvenient of times. As the episode drags on, Willow continuously embarrasses Ariana again and again, especially at the pub at the Snuggly Duckling, where she tells really embarrassing stories about Ariana, and that she and Ariana used to be nicknamed Dariana, because she was so desperate to impress Willow. Ariana and Rapunzel have been looking forward to seeing the special meteor shower together, for the first time ever. And Ariana has this conversation with Frederick, where she's pretty much talking the whole time, and Frederick just looks at her and nods, doesn't really say a word. And then she says, you know what, tonight's about me and Rapunzel. Besides, Willow doesn't really know. Mom, guess who wants to come over? It's like, and the moment we realize who's coming over, it's like, no! So, Willow comes along and irritates Ariana even further. Hell, we even have a bell toll for a commercial break. And Ariana gets so fed up with her that when Rapunzel's distracted for a minute, Ariana tells her off for being very sporadic, very danger-like, and so forth. But, and then just walks away saying she needs a minute, but of course she's by herself for quite a long time, and she gets fed up with the gerbil's rattling, that she takes the rattle away and throws it off carelessly. Then she gets distracted by the meteor shower, as does Rapunzel and Willow. Then there's another confrontation just moments later, and Willow tells off Ariana saying, you always have to have a plan. You always have to be so straightforward. You can never just have fun. Ariana goes off on her saying, I would try to tell you, but even if I did, you wouldn't listen because you don't know a single thing about a single responsibility. And Then Rapunzel, having found the gerbil, sees that the gerbil pukes out, not hair this time, because he was puking out hair earlier, but pukes out literally clones of himself. These freaky little things that multiply. And at first, the gang tries to get the rattle back and tries to get their attention, but it doesn't work. Also, meanwhile, the King Frederick decides to go on a last-minute camping trip with Lance and Eugene, and it doesn't go so well, especially since Lance keeps bringing up the wrong topics of conversation to the King, and they get into a fight. And then they get caught in the whole multiple gerbil craze. They barely get away. Eventually, the group improvises this plan to find the original gerbil by using Rapunzel's telescope. That's what the gift was a telescope. They use a telescope to magnify the rattler, and then they use a glider to glide above the gerbil hordes, and they do get the attention of the original gerbil and give the rattle back to him. And now that he has the rattle back, he literally absorbs all the hundreds or thousands of other gerbils that are ravaging around, almost ravaging Corona. And then everything comes together. The following day, Willow and Ariana say their farewells. Ariana and Rapunzel confide with each other about having what the good things about having Willow around and the bad things about having her around. And hey, at least she gets to take care of the gerbil now. And then right then and there, the gerbil's right in front of them with the rattle. And then you hear both Ariana and Rapunzel call out, "Willow!" And the episode ends. This was a really fun episode. I think one of the things that really stands out about this one is that this is one that includes not only Ariana, but both her and Frederick. You actually see the royal parents, the king and queen themselves, be part of the story, and it's really good. You know, this isn't just like the seventh episode, In Like Flynn, where it was just all about Eugene and Frederick pulling a big prank on a rival king. They both work everybody works together, particularly Ariana and her sister, to save the kingdom from something that Ariana unconsciously unleashed. And, you know, there's a lot of patience with Ariana. I really like how there's a lot of patience with Ariana in this episode for the sake of her own sister, who I assume is not voiced by the same actress, Julie Bowen, but... And it's good to see Rapunzel have fun with her aunt. They even have this thing where, like, They both don't wear shoes or socks of any kind. You know, that's what they have in common. Rapunzel gets the infamous no shoes thing from her aunt, or no socks thing from her aunt. And even though she has a lot of fun with her, she acknowledges that, yeah, she can be a bit excessive with her dangerous ways. There's a lot of good in this episode. This is definitely another solid B+. Whew, I'm giving a lot of B+s to this series, aren't I? But that's just how good of a show this is. I don't remember if there's really much more of Ariana-esque stories that happen later on in this series, let alone this season, but I'm glad we did have a really solid one for this episode. Thank you, everybody, for joining me once again. I am the Spirit Man, the Embracer of Human Good, and Analyst of Fiction, and I'll see you guys in the next Tangled Vlogs very, very soon. Take care, everybody.